Welcome back to OS Bridge Tech Love Live. We're joined by Maria Webster. Hi, Maria.
Hi, Cammie.
How you doing?
Good to meet you again.
Good to meet you again. Where can we find you on Twitter and online?
Ubergeek. UBERGEEKE. I was told that's the old English spelling.
Ubergeek.
I don't know what. Exactly.
I don't know which camera that.
Also, .51.com. .51 Geek Space for Women, and that's .51 spelled out. .51.
That's two people today with the dot spelled out. I feel like I need a dot somewhere.
All right, Cammie.
Cammie.chaos. Oh, maybe I can get that. I don't know. I'm going to make a mental note. I'm just going to file that away for later. Okay, so you're speaking today and you're giving a unicorn talk.
I'm giving the unicorn talk. I did not find out about the unicorn law until yesterday, and I'm not a unicorn fan, so I'm slightly upset by this. Mm-hmm. I mean, maybe if it was the griffin talk or
other mythological creatures are okay.
Yes.
Okay, just not the unicorn. What do you have against the unicorn? I know someone's going to be very upset. He loves unicorns.
They don't come in the Strange Love Live color scheme.
I once saw this like awesome. It was at a carnival, and you know when you do the stupid prizes, and it was like this mirror thing painted, and it was a red unicorn with a black horn and like all this black. It was like painted like a Clydesdale.
Nice.
It was awesome. I had no place to put it.
That unicorn might be okay
because they're too dainty. Is it because they're all like,
No, it's just an old joke about my hating unicorns. I don't really hate unicorns.
Okay.
I mean, some of my best friends are unicorns.
All right, you know? That's cool. It's all good.
Unicorns suck, but not really, right.
It's okay. It's all right. We'll just have to hashtag this unicorn for Marshall Kirkpatrick so that he can be like, somebody hates unicorns.
That's a new hashtag that's born of this conference. I think we should start that. Hashtag unicorn law.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you didn't know about the unicorn law.
I did not.
So you didn't know you were giving a unicorn talk.
I did not. My talk is about being a woman on the fringe of open source, mm-hmm. and I did not realize that a sort of a price of entry as a woman in the open source movement is to give a talk about being a woman in the open source movement. So, new revelation.
But that is what your talk is about.
That's what I'm talking about.
We need to retitle it. I could go around with a Sharpie and just scribble out all the...
Well, the other thing that I'll be talking about later today is the perception that in order to be active in the community, you need to contribute to the kernel. You need to contribute to specific code sets. Mm-hmm. And I don't think that's true. So for a long time, I viewed myself as being on the fringe of the movement because I wasn't writing code for the kernel. Mm-hmm. But I've been using Linux since 97. So
I'd say that qualifies
as
involvement.
You know.
Oh, look, I'm dancing around for 12 years.
Dressed as a unicorn.
I'm looking for a... You know, do you remember those Dealey Bobbers that they used to make with the... I wonder if they make...
We can make one.
Yeah,
sure.
I'm sure we could. I've got Gaffer's tape. We could probably make one from scratch.
Somebody's got some duct tape around here.
So. Oh, it's black duct tape. So.
Oh,
yeah, it's
there
just
you go.
That you don't want the
theater
shiny.
Geek. Yeah.
Yeah. It's okay. What time is your talk?
My talk's at 3:50.
At 3:50?
This afternoon in Steel, I believe.
3:50 in the Steel Room.
Steel.
A unicorn.
Steel. That sounds... very rugged.
What do you want to tell us about embedded systems?
I'm really psyched about embedded systems. I am currently in one of the many hats that I wear. I'm also studying electrical engineering at Portland State University, and one of the interests I have is in embedded systems, and specifically Linux for embedded systems. I am trying to learn as much as I can, so I've attended a couple of the sessions here that were hardware related, and I'm actually going to be crunching some C code when no one's looking, so...
You know, there's a hacker lounge for that.
Yes, I do, but
I
there
I
doesn't
your
seem to be any beer there.
Yeah. You know what I heard? And I'm saying this because we're doing the show tomorrow night from the hacker lounge. You are allowed to bring up any booze you want to from the bar.
Really?
Downstairs. You can go down to the bar and get the alcohol and take it back up with you.
Well, assuming they have Guinness at the bar, then, you know, things may go well.
Yeah, you should check that out because that's what I'm planning to do tomorrow night. Not the Guinness. I'm going to go downstairs, get some gin, bring it up, be a happy host. It'll be
that's
good.
Right.
And bless, see, I have all my beautiful cards. They're very helpful.
Excellent.
You are a performing musician, which is kind of how I met you, but not because you were playing music.
Right. I've been performing in the Portland area, the greater Northwest, for more years. You know, after a certain number of years, you're not supposed to mention how many years it's been?
Correct.
Yeah, 20 years.
Yeah.
Folk rock,
what
R&B, soul stuff.
What instrument?
I play the acoustic guitar. Well, guitar, but I perform acoustically generally. So.
Unplugged acoustically? Or, I mean, do you just have the guitar? There's nothing plugged in? You got a microphone?
Generally, no. I have a really big mouth, so I generally don't need a microphone. This almost seems unnecessary, but...
Well, yeah, it's the people across the country.
Yeah, they might want to hear what's going on. Yeah. I generally perform unamplified, but, yeah, sometimes.
Where are you performing?
Coffee shops right now, because I'm busy writing code and doing electrical engineering and embedded systems things. But sometimes I'll play at Cooper's Coffee House. I think I might be playing at... And this isn't confirmed yet, but just to put a bug in anyone's ear who's interested, I may be performing at Peacock After Dark this fall.
Very cool. Very, very cool.
Yeah.
Before you go, I want you to tell us a little bit more about .51.
.51 is a site that I put together a year ago when I couldn't find a site on the web, believe it or not. When you have a million monkeys typing, you should be able to find just about anything on the internet. And I was looking for a site that was focused on what geeky women were doing. Mm-hmm. I found a number of sites that were about geeky women looking for jobs or geeky women complaining about the hassle they get for being geeky women. But I did not find a site that focused on what a bunch of different geeky women were doing at any given time. What are they hacking on? What are they writing about? What are they building? So I built it. And .51 does exactly that. It focuses on what geeky women are doing now. You're a theater geek. You're probably next. So,
hello.
So yeah, that's what that's for. It's I passed the 6-month evil blog mark, where most blogs go to die, mm-hmm. And things are going very well with that.
I didn't know about it until you wrote a post about the OS Bridge conference, and then I found it, and I was like, oh. And then I was like, oh, I've met her.
I kind of like how that works. You know, the magic of the internet in this town is that, you know, you find out about something from somebody who's doing something else.
Yeah.
It works great.
It is a good way to go. All right, Maria, it was great to have you on. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thanks for sneaking me in.
3:00?
3:50.
3:50. Okay. Everyone go see the unicorn talk.
The unicorn
That's
talk.
That's not really a unicorn talk.
Exactly.
But it is. All right. Thank you so much.
Thanks.